More than a dozen missiles launched from Iran struck two air bases in Erbil and Al-Sad, west of Baghdad. It is unclear if there have been any casualties. The initial response from Washington has been muted. President Trump tweeted that all was well and said casualties and damages were being assessed. Two Iraqi bases housing U.S. and coalition troops were targeted, one at Al-Asad and one at Erbil, at about 2 a.m. local time on Wednesday. It came just hours after the burial of Soleimani, who controlled Iran's proxy forces across the Middle East. Iran's Supreme Leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei said the attack was a slap in the face for the U.S. and called for an end to the U.S. presence in the Middle East. Echoing him, President Hassan Rouhani said Iran's final answer to Soleimani's assassination will be to kick all U.S. forces out of the region. Iraq's Prime Minister, meanwhile, Adel Abdul Mahdi, said Iran had warned him just after midnight local time that an attack was imminent and only areas with U.S. troops will be targeted. There were no reports of Iraqi casualties. Just hours after the missile strikes, a Ukrainian airliner crashed in Iran shortly after takeoff. There is no evidence that the two incidents are linked. Several airlines have announced that they are avoiding both Iranian and Iraqi airspace amid the rising tension. This is the most direct assault by Iran on the U.S. since the seizing of the U.S. embassy in Tehran in 1979. Iran's Revolutionary Guard said the attack was in retaliation for the death of Soleimani on Friday, killed in a missile strike outside Baghdad airport on the orders of President Donald Trump, and warned U.S. allies that their bases could also be targeted.